We are at Mickey's Pub in Kelowna. We were supposed to be at Nakasp Hot Springs, but because of the travel restriction in BC, in Canada, we couldn't go, and plus they
cancel our reservations.
Cancel the reservations. So we stayed home.
Yes, we have a couple of days off, so we're just gonna enjoy,
I don't know, going around.
Yeah, it's first time when we're coming out for lunch in 14 years.
Yes.
Can you believe that?
No, we were always working. We came for like dinners and stuff, but with the kids, and but now by ourselves, the kids are at school, everybody's at work.
Yeah, we left the girls before on Christmas parties to our friends, couple good friends. And we never came out for lunch in 14 years together,
no.
Just me and you.
No, no, now is the first time.
So these days we're gonna take it easy, and
we're gonna enjoy our week off. I don't know. What do you wanna do? Go for a walk. Go for a hike.
Hike, a walk.
Go fishing.
Maybe go fishing.
And I do still have some chores around the house that you have to do.
Some honey to-do list.
some honey to-do list, yeah.
We will see. We're just going to take it easy.
Yeah. And let's enjoy our lunch because I'm a little hungry.
Yeah, I'm out. We are out and the wings and the salad with the steak looks so good.
It does. Let's see what happened. Oh, yeah. They did it the medium. I can't believe everybody's at work and we are not. I can't believe that. Are they yummy?
Oh, so good.
I would like this week to go fishing. What do you think?
We can go fishing.
I would like to go fishing.
We have to renew the license.
Mm-hmm. We will.
The fishing license, it's like $36 in Canada.
If we're lucky, in August we have some time off and we booked some amazing camping sites. We're hoping the restrictions are not going to be there so we can go, but who knows what's happening until August. So I have my fingers crossed.
Like this vacation was supposed to be so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Going to hot springs.
Yeah, camping there and
camping.
We have some great hikes over there, but we were supposed to go to the natural hot springs also.
Yeah, and we got an email from the Nakasp hot springs that our reservations are canceled.
Exactly.
They send us the money back.
Mm-hmm.
And
oh well.
I don't know, but I hope the summer vacation we can we're gonna make it to Yoho and Banff.
Mm-hmm. And Jasper. We wanna go to all three national parks. Yoho National Park, Banff National Park, and then Jasper. To visit all the glacier lakes. Yeah, the Bascan Glacier, everything around there.
How many weeks do we have off?
Two.
2 weeks. 2 weeks of no work.
Mm-hmm.
And just exploring and new adventures.
I booked everything. I just hope we can go.
How did you book it?
Online through BC Parks. I was waiting in a line to book Banff National Park in Yoho. They were ahead of me 25,000 people and I still got a spot.
She wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning.
I did.
2 days in a row.
I did. For Yoho and for Banff.
Just to be sure, when they opening the reservation at 7 o'clock.
She's
right there.
And I waited for like 4 hours and then I got a reservation. The Jasper. The reservation are gonna be in June. They are building a brand new 800 spots camping right beside Jasper. And that's going to be really cool. So I'm waiting for June to book that on. Another day, waking up at 4 o'clock. I tried to book in between Jasper and Banff. I couldn't get any. Everything was so booked.
But also, in between Jasper and Banff, it's first come, first serve.
Yeah, there's a lot of spots that they're first come, first serve.
Maybe more than half of the...
Yeah, only two. So, only two campsites you can book in between. The rest are first come, first serve, which is a lot. They have some for first come, first serve camping spot at the Bascom Glacier. Right there in the parking lot, you know, where all the... So we'll see. We'll see.
If we're gonna make it.
I hope we will. I wanna go with a canoe on Lake Louise. Then there's Emerald Lake in Yoho National Park, which is amazing. There's lots of lakes there. Lots of hikes to do. Lots of things to see. So, keeping our fingers crossed. That August is going to be good.
When you eat wings, you have to get messy.
You do.
Otherwise, you're not eating wings. So that why I'm digging in here. The other thing, finger licking food, are, mom?
Which one?
Shrimps.
The best shrimps ever, they are in Chilwa.
Yeah.
I don't know where that pub is called.
So it's a pub. I'm gonna put the link here down below, the name. The pub in Chilwa, they making the best shrimp ever. Finger licking food. Cheers. Mom, look at where I got you today.
Where?
It's a beautiful park. It's called the Glenmore Mountain Park. And you have a gorgeous view over Kelowna. Are you excited to see it?
Yep. Don't put me to go home by myself because I don't know how to get back.
Wow, look at the beautiful view.
Mm-hmm.
You can see everything from here, from the top. The golf course, lake, Knox Mountain. What's that mountain over there, mom?
Which one?
The one straight ahead.
Let me get my orientation skill in order.
That's the Bushery Mountain.
Bushery. So that's west side.
West side.
West side.
Let's...
Oh yeah, I can see the bridge.
Let's check the view around. Beautiful Kelowna. You must love it.
I can see the people golfing on the golf course here.
Right underneath.
Yeah.
And it's one guy already with the boat out. Two boats, three boats.
Where do you see them? Oh yeah, one, two, three, yeah. That's.
Oh, right. That guy goes over there.
That guy is lucky, but the lake is so crystal clear today, so it's very nice.
Let's see if you guys can see the boats. On the lake. That's downtown. The bridge is over there. If I can see that boat from here, it must be at least 40 feet long. It's right there behind the hospital. So if I'm gonna put the lavender mom here, right in front, it's gonna be like that much. Huh?
But that thing needs to come out because it's dried.
Yeah, I'm gonna take it out.
Now.
Next year.
No, now, because it's dry.
Holy smoke.
I take it out because it's dry. That's why we bought the lavender. I told you it's dry, look.
If you look, rip a little bit, look,
yeah, but
it's all dry out.
It's that side, the back side is still okay.
This doesn't work here anyway.
I know what I'm gonna do. Go and bring me the plant cutter. The scissor or how it's called, that thing.
Okay. Where is it?
In the garage. If not, in a shed. I'm telling you that much. That plant over there, the rhododendrons, how it's called, is not, it's half dead, but the other half is still alive. I'm not gonna take it out, the whole plant. I just gonna chop it half the plant, like the dry side, and I'm gonna keep the green side. Maybe till next year to see if it's gonna come up again, but it might be on the way out, so. She might be right, but don't tell her. Shh.
And after that, you have to go to plant the peas for me.
Holy,
and
so
the zucchini plants.
So much work to do, guys.
And then you have to fix the fence.
What?
You have to fix the fence.
I'm telling you, around the house, the work never ends. Just to show you what I did with the lavender, I put it right here in the corner, so when it's gonna grow, it's not gonna go over the walk path. And the little rhododendron, which I kept it and I think is still alive, is this guy here. So we're gonna keep it for another year or so. And if it's gonna survive, it's gonna survive. If not, I'm gonna take it out.
My honey to do this is to take out the dandelions. And what are these? Dandelions. Wheat.
And there are some people who they even have a salad with dandelions. And the salad at the superstore, they have dandelions leaf.
Exactly.
Some of them. So mom, are you throwing away some food?
Some food. Wanna eat this? Be my guest. Okay.
You miss one.
Look. What?
You miss this plant here.
Here you go.
I have the mother-in-law eyes. Nothing flies by.
I remember now when we grew up and we were going to the countryside at my grandma and grandpa. And we were working the fields, like cornfield or sunflower field or peas, or we were going to the winery, to the grape field. So now it's time to clean up the field for our garden. Like we said, the ground is a little bit rocky, but look at the plant. Wow, look at the roots. It has roots and everything, so it might survive. Ah, the plant is so cute, so little and cute. What do you think is gonna grow? Of course, because I planted. Bye, zucchini. See you later. Time to do the peas. Oh, come on, peas, out. Two peas in a pond. Or in this case, three peas in a pond.
Rocco,
don't. Do not dig my zucchini.
And after that, if you do the sides of the grass, I will cut the grass quickly and then we're done.
And then we're done for today?
Well, we have the fence.
Oh, so we're not done.
We're not done. We have the fence. Are you gonna eat sweet peas or not really?
Me? I will try.
Those are like very good for like a snack.
Oh, so those are the sweet peas?
Yeah, the ones that they're very sweet and you don't eat them. Those are.
Don't say them up. I love them.
Yeah.
Let's make like a dam to keep the water on the peas side.
And now I have to water them mostly every day almost.
Every day, mom. You have to do what you have to do.
I know.
Okay, my peas are so happy now.
Look. They're outside.
Yeah.
Did you catch any fish?
Not yet. We're waiting for the big one. I'm doing sport fishing. Mm. Catching and releasing.
Okay.
It was one that big. That big and a little girl.
I think the loon is eating all the fish. For sure. They're catching more fish than us. Where's the fish, Toko? I want to see the fish. Look at the big fish that's coming.
Help me take it out. It's so big. My hand is sore. We're getting slowly back in the business. After the winter, not doing nothing, we're fishing.
But there's no fish.
There is fish, but
at the superstore.
They don't want to come.
There's fish at superstore.
Superstore, the freezers are full. Roll, roll, roll your boat
gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. The line's in the water for sure. Now we're getting all the fish in the lake.
The way we're rolling here with the fishing rods on the side, I feel like we are the big fishing boats.
We have this teeny weeny boat
on the ocean. You know what I'm talking about?
The big fisherman boats.
Yeah,
that they fish for tuna or for
everything. Look at us with the setup here.
One fishing rod.
Going crazy.
And two fishing rods.